Asia Minor, what we called Anatolia, one of the oldest places hosting the oldest civilizations from the both East and West, witnessed most of the first time inventions, temples, settlements and buildings. As Turkey, all this history provides us an upscale multicultural background and living that makes a unique culture with full of success. So, we decide to mention the facts of Turkey. This is Sherif the Broker. Welcome to Basic Info. Let's start with current and critical points. Before anything else, Turkey is a NATO country, which makes it officially a first world country by sending an army of 5,000 soldiers to the Korean War, occurred in 1950. Turkey got the right of joining NATO and it has maintained its membership since then. Secondly, Turkey is a G20 country, which means one of the top rich countries in the world. As a footnote, G20 countries are ruling 75% of the total world economy. Next, Turkey is the sixth visited country with the number of 45 million foreign visitors yearly. But why do so many people prefer to visit Turkey? It can be either a historical or a natural trip, as well as it can be for summer vacation. Because Turkey has the longest coastway to the Mediterranean Sea, and the third country which has the most blue flag beaches. Blue flag beach means the type of beaches having white sand and azure waters so that they are awarded a blue flag. We have lots of blue flag beaches along the coastway of Asian and Mediterranean Seas. The most outstanding cities are Antalya, Fethiye, Marmaris, Bodrum, Çeşme and Kuşadası for an amazing holiday trip next to the blue flag beaches. Natural beauties are not limited to them. Peri Bacaları, Pamukkale, Kaz Mountains, Mount Olympus, Ölüdeniz, more and more. You can discover hundreds of natural formations all around Turkey. One of the most interesting examples for it is Salda Lake, where the surrounding of the lake is the only place on Earth which is consisting of the same surface components as Mars. These places are so beautiful that once upon a time, Alanya was gifted to Cleopatra by Mark Antony. Not by the singer one, by the emperor Mark Antony. So when we come to the cultural part, just like a mosaic, it is not surprising to see amazing works of a different civilization under every piece of stone because of the handovers among the civilizations for thousands of years. One of the most striking examples we see is seven holy churches that are important for Christian pilgrims. The House of Virgin Mary and Basilica of St. John in Izmir, Kora Church, Hagia Sophia and Hagia Irene in Istanbul, and Cathedral of the Holy Cross in Van are located in different parts of Turkey and still open for visits. When we go back thousands of years ago from that time, we see that Turkey hosts many world heritages. Two of the seven wonders of the world are located in Turkey. Temple of Artemis at Ephesus in Izmir and Mausoleum at Halikarnassus in Bodrum. You may think that Greece and Egypt have more wonders than us, but the reality is these three countries have the equal number of wonders. When we even go back much more than these wonders, Göbekli Tepe in Şanlıurfa has been the first temple discovered by mankind until now. The 12,000-year-old temple is 5,000 years older than Stonehenge. Besides, the first settlement in human history, Çatalhöyük, and the largest excavated underground city in Cappadocia, which could house 20,000 people, are situated in Turkey as well. So, when we approach today a little bit, we see that Turks also play a key role in affecting ages periodically. First, the Turks started the end of ancient history through Turkic migration from Central Asia to Europe in 3-4 BC by sweeping communities in between so that they forced the other nations to the migration as well. That created a snowball effect from the east to the west and caused the fall of the Western Roman Empire. On the other hand, by conquering the last castle of the Eastern Roman Empire, Constantinople, Turks sealed up another historic period, once again called the Middle Age. Both of them brought enormous change worldwide, at least the world at those times, because no other ran Anatolia is an important place for logistics and trade through the seas around. Bosphorus and warm temperature climate that provides four seasonal living space. Then what happened after the Turks arrived at Anatolia? Most of the developments started happening generally in the period of the Ottoman Empire. The first coffee was made in and spread, thank you Yiğit, Turkish coffee. Nice. The first coffee was made in and spread from the Ottoman Empire with Turkish coffee. Thanks to Hürrem Sultan, the wife of Süleyman the Magnificent, cafes were opened in some part of the empire so that cafe culture was established for the first time. Next, the second metro line in the world was constructed between İstiklal and Beşiktaş in 1875. This metro is still active that you can experience when you come to Istanbul. Let's keep going. Turkey is the only country that gained its independence by fighting against six different countries. Also, Turkey takes place in one of the pioneer countries that women got the right to vote in 1930, while France was in 1944 and Switzerland in 1977. Previous people and civilizations performed so proudful act for thousands of years and left unique masterpieces in the whole of Anatolia. But as a country on these lands in the 2000s, what have we done in the last few years? What have been the success of Turkey in this century? When we come to the 2000s, if you follow the international developments from any field, you will see some signatures of Turks under the achievements of many international sports, economic, art and scientific events. We will start with the millennium, but before the 2000s, I want to touch on the success of a gorgeous Turkish weightlifter, Naim Süleymanoğlu. During Seoul Olympiad in 1988, he lifted 190 kilograms, which is the 3 times plus 10 kilograms more of his weight and broke a record of all time. He was very short, as you see, that's why we were calling from Hercules in the pocket. Best regards. So in the first year of the 2000s, Galatasaray won the UEFA Cup. Turkish national team became the third in 2002 FIFA World Cup. In the same year, Azra Akın was crowned Miss World 2002. Sertab Erener was awarded the prize of Eurovision in 2003. Orhan Pamuk was considered worthy of Nobel Literature Prize in 2006. Nuri Bilge Ceylan won Cannes Film Festival 2 times in 2003 and 2011. Fenerbahçe basketball team won EuroLeague Championship in 2015.
Bobby Dixon saate baktı, geçti onu. Bobby Dixon!
Attı!
Bir! Bobby Dixon tepede çok kırık.
Attı!
Bobby! Sayın arkadaşlar, sayın! 20'den geldi bu takım.
Haluk Bilginer won the Best Performance by an Actor Award at Emmy in 2020. Anadolu Efes and another Turkish basketball team became EuroLeague champion once again last week. And when we come to the last and the most important figures of Turkey worldwide, of course we cannot jump over these two precious scientists, Uğur Şahin and Özlem Türeci, who are the founders of BioNTech and the developers of COVID vaccine, which brings us hope to leave these quarantine days behind. Thank you for watching. Today we explained the facts of Turkey. You have seen, maybe you didn't know about this history, but we have these kind of successful people and the history take Turks and Turkey until this time. And we are hoping to have more and more successes in the future. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. If I forgot any facts about Turkey, you can comment under the video. See you on the next episode. The Broker is out.